Good evening, everyone. So we are going to talk about network visibility in hybrid and multi clouds. So let's have a quick introduction about ourselves. So that is my GitHub ID. I'm Suresh, and I have around 15 years of experience in cloud, telecom, and geospatial technologies. And I'm a CloudStack contributor since last 4+ years. And currently, I'm a software engineer at Accelerite. So,
yeah, I'm Harikrishna. Same with me, I work for Accelerite, and I have 7+ years of experience in the development. So we work on a product called Cloud Platform, which is open source version is CloudStack under Apache. So I'm a committer in Apache CloudStack since 5 years.
So this is what you can expect from our talk. So we will go through the introduction of what network visibility is, and just cover the challenges around the network across the clouds, and we will cover few use cases and the business impacts out of that. So these all based on our experience in the current product and federating between Apache CloudStack and AWS. Okay, so so coming to internet, so network visibility is it provides a platform for like dig into the network and get to know the details in a granular level. So it answers several questions like what are the resources in use and who is using them, and you can trace the actual network flows using the network insights provided from the visibility. And within a cloud environment, so if a particular virtual machine has to reach another virtual machine in another cloud in hybrid or multi-cloud environment, so you can get the details of that, and you can check the various policies set and what are the policies stopping your traffic flow, and what are the misconfigurations within our network rules, so that you can reconfigure that. And even you, from the network insights, you can get the different traffic patterns, and you can predict the future traffic, and you can get to know like what is the next traffic after 36 hours or in a day. So even with knowing the network insights, you can get to know what are the tools required in the network so as to improve your network stability, and so that you can integrate with other monitoring tools or any out of band tools. So so basically at a high level, the visibility provides end-to-end traffic flow from one cloud to another cloud across hybrid or multi clouds, with which you can know the actual data flow between the clouds, which can be used for various analytics. Okay, and in the hybrid and multi cloud environment, so there is a various network activities. So this network visibility will give you a detailed report of the network activity within the clouds, which administrators can take a look and use it for root causing or troubleshooting or improving their policies, and maybe doing the better configuration to improve the speed of a particular network links. And even you can get a like a broader review of the network patterns or the network flows within a hybrid and multi-cloud environment. Okay, so these are the challenges in the current hybrid and multi-cloud environment. So basically this environment, whatever within the clouds is a complex, it has a multi-vendor appliances and multiple service providers, and it uses a diverse hardware and software platforms. So it is hard to monitor each and every appliance. So this visibility will provide a easy way so as to monitor each and every appliance within within the environment, and you can get good insights out of that. And network choking. So if anyone wants to like the administrator want to know where actually the choke has happened, so it is very difficult to figure out in a complex environment. So and network patterns. So if you want to check different network patterns from various clouds, and what are the resources which is using a huge bandwidth in that network. So finding with the current monitoring tools is quite a bit difficult with that. And tracking the history. So if you want to know what has happened last week within my cloud environment, or what has happened in last day in my cloud environment, so how do you track the history? So you don't have anything to track the history. So suppose there was a security threat an attack within your network. So how do you track that? So that is also one challenging area in a multi-cloud and hybrid environment, and performance. So as the there is a huge data volume and the network traffic flows between various virtual machines and the network appliances in the cloud and environment. So the performance is also an important aspect, performance and the scalability of the network. So these are the challenges which we came across, and with the network visibility, the solution which my friend will propose, so we can get some information about various insights into the network and just overcome these challenges. So my friend will just go through the other details about the cloud environment. Thank you.
Thanks, Suresh. So before going into the complete details of network visibility, by the way, am I audible? Okay. So before going to the network visibility insights, I just want to give you a quick intro for how cloud environment, what are all the cloud environments we have. We have, on-premise cloud technologies, which means if organizations have its own infrastructure, they can build their own cloud, or they can manage themselves. The other one is the public clouds like AWS or Google Cloud Platform or Microsoft Azure. They have their own infrastructure and they provide us some services so that we can use them. So both have their own advantages and disadvantages. So the mix of these two can be the hybrid clouds where most of the people are tend to use that. Like it's say for on-premise cloud technologies, we have the complete control of the infrastructure. If say something, if you want to have a I mean, our own deployment, like where we want to keep the routers or switches and how the complete lab is under control. And even we can deploy some network tabs or some network aggregators within our infrastructure. So even public clouds also, they are easy and fast to spin up any applications. Say if I own a website, if I develop a website on a public clouds, I deploy a website. If I want to, double that load, I can easily spawn some other applications and make it work on the public clouds easily. I mean, same with, we can do with on-premise clouds also, but it will be a little easier and faster on public clouds. So to mix both these clouds, we can have the hybrid clouds. An organization has a huge demand of traffic in a year, if they have only 1 month having huge demand of the traffic, they don't need to have on-premise infrastructure all over the year. They can use this public cloud for that month itself. So there the hybrid cloud comes into picture. So coming to the network visibility across this hybrid cloud. So before going into the use cases, based on the challenges my friend has talked about. So this is all based upon our experience on Apache CloudStack. If we get most of the escalations around networking area only. I mean, there might be some router issues or there might be some networking issues. Every time we have to go into the router, whether it could be a virtual router or a physical router, we have to log into the router and troubleshoot it individually. That is a little a pain point. So what we thought of, we had looked for some this kind of network visibility applications. There are many applications in the market, but what we thought is to reduce the cost by using the existing flow traffic protocols. There are a lot many flow traffic protocols which capture the network flow. We can capture them and use within our applications. So like if we have the network visibility upon our cloud, we can, as we said, we can troubleshoot it properly. And if there are any blind spots, say suppose if I have 10 routers in my network infrastructure and I'm not sure what happened to one of the routers, the complete network has shut down, or a VPC tier has not getting the traffic. So in that case, we can find the blind spots easily. And even the policy compliance also, most of the organizations are now using those policy compliances. So based on the data we get, because this network, we capture that, whatever the data we capture that, so we can assure these policy compliances and placement strategies. We deploy hybrid clouds. So we have both on-premise VMs and the VMs on the public clouds as well. So based on the monitoring or analysis we done on the network traffic, we can decide if a VM can be placed in on-premise VM or a public VM. It might not be suitable on a normal on-premise infrastructure. So we can move it to the public cloud. Same with the configuration as well. The deployment that we have might need some configuration changes. So with this network visibility, we can change the configuration so that it works much better. So the business impact is little, similar. If we have this network visibility, we can have the enhanced customer experience, and we can build the robust platforms by changing the placement strategies or changing the configurations. And even by finding out the network patterns, we can figure out some of the security, we can solve some of the security concerns as well. If there is any difference in the network pattern, usual network pattern, so we can find out what happened and we can quickly go through and check it. So I am not proposing a complete solution, but this is the basic network visibility in a normal network infrastructure. I mean, there are a lot other network visibility applications, but those might be costlier. But with the, as I told you, there are many flow traffic protocols that we can use and make it working network visibility. If say these are the rack of the servers I have on which there might be cloud or the way I can use it as it is, and the network infrastructure on top of the servers. So this is the system I have. So on top of it, I want to have this network visibility around the on the traffic that is being flowing across these routers and switches. So what we, so the basic fundamental of network visibility is to capture the network traffic. There are multiple solutions to capture that. We can use either of the ways, but I'm just explaining some of the hardware and software things that we can use. So say suppose that the traffic from the servers going through this network infrastructure from the routers to the switches, and the traffic flows between these servers. I mean, these can be VMs as well. So what we can do is we can keep an NTAP. So this is network test access points. So this is an hardware appliance. So this will simply capture the network flowing from the routers to the switches within that network infrastructure. So the problem with these NTAPs is that this is an hardware appliance and this might be costlier at times. I mean, based on the cloud deployment we have. And there is another port mirroring that we can use in the switches. So what NTAP actually does is it will simply duplicates the network traffic without touching the actual traffic. So it will just duplicates the traffic and sends it to the network traffic collector. So this we have to implement. NTAP only provides a way to send it to some endpoint. So this network traffic, we have to write that and collect it and send it to the corresponding network monitor, whether it could be troubleshooting or any security monitor. So there is other way to send the traffic to the network traffic collector, which is called SPAN, which is a switched port analyzer. So which is basically port mapping. So as I said, network NTAP does the complete network duplication. But what SPAN does is we can configure it per port. I mean, we can duplicate the traffic from port to port, port A to port B. So we can decide what are all the ports can be monitored and send that traffic to the network collector. And from there, we can forward it to the monitors. So if say I'm totally talking about with respect to the network infrastructure, if say I don't have the access to the network infrastructure, if say I have a cloud deployed on this servers. I mean, as I said, we worked on Apache CloudStack, right? This is an IaaS platform, infrastructure as a service platform. So which provides a cloud on top of the existing servers. So in that there are many virtual routers, VMs, and many other network appliances, software network appliances. So there I can't deploy these NTAPs. Maybe I can configure a SPAN, but not NTAPs. So there what we have to do is in VMs, there is something called virtual NTAPs. So we can, I mean, that's making use of the OS level capabilities to capture the network at the interface level and send it to the network traffic collector. So instead of using the hardware appliances, we can use the virtual NTAPs. So that's on the normal cloud. If we have hybrid clouds. So say this is my on-premise cloud and this is my public cloud. So what all I can do is, so whatever the traffic flows within this network, I can capture it and send it to the monitors. But the problem comes with the public cloud. I only have the access to the services or the VMs on the public cloud, not directly to the servers. So I can't deploy NTAPs or even I can't deploy a SPAN on these switches. So what we can do is, so even if say if we put a load balancer between this cloud, private cloud and this public cloud, I can only monitor the complete traffic going to this public cloud, not each and every VM. So the same thing that we were talking about, the VMs deployed on these servers, so we have to also have a tapping agent installed on each and every VM we deploy it on public clouds. So what that will do is tapping agents will send the traffic to the network traffic collector, and from there it will send it to the monitor. So these tapping agents can be either simple Java agents, or it can be any Docker containers or anything that is up to our deployment development. So we need to have these tapping agents for sure on these public clouds. So how we can achieve this is, so since we in our Apache Cloud Stack, we have done an integration with AWS. So we have done a project called Cloud Federation, which will actually unifies the cloud, on-premise cloud and the public cloud. So we will have a unified, so we don't even have two interfaces. We'll have only one interface. We can deploy the VM, we can tell where it can be deployed. We can directly deploy it on the on-premise machine or on the public cloud. So there we got this problem of network network visibility. That's where we thought of looking into some solution, and we are still working on it, not yet completed, but we are trying to deploy these kind of agents on the VMs. So there in the tapping agents, what we are using is there are multiple network flow protocols like NetFlow, which is a Cisco proprietary, and there are many other vendor specific NetFlow protocols. So there we, in that NetFlow protocol, we are using that to send the traffic to the network traffic controller. So the biggest question is, this is an on-premise network and this is a public network. So what we have done to send the traffic from these servers to the network traffic collector is to have a VPN connection between these two servers. I mean, this collector will be deployed somewhere on the servers only. So there will be a VPN connection so that the complete traffic will be duplicated and send it to the network traffic collector. So this network traffic collector, either this can be so whatever the tapping agents we have deployed here, there should be a receiver over here also. So in some cases we have deployed that receiver outside of the network traffic collector, and we send the traffic and forward the traffic again to the network traffic collector, and from then we'll send it to the network monitors. So again, the network monitors solutions, there are multiple solutions based on the network that we capture. We are using some other solutions, not we are writing these solutions, we are just trying to make this working on our own, like in deploying the tapping agents and sending it to the network traffic collector. So we already have some span related development on our switches. So that is already done, but this yet need to be done. Yeah. So that's what we are working on. Maybe in our next sessions we'll be demoing on that. Not now, maybe in the next conferences or something. If, we are done, if you have any questions.